thought it was sensational for Luke. I was really impressed with my team the last 36 minutes of the game. The first 4 minutes, I thought we were awful. We went out there just cool. I don't like cool. And we missed the first 7 or 8 shots and had 3 or 4 turnovers during that time period. I got 5 guys up to put them in the game. I was going to take the 5 guys on the court out. And they made 3 plays in a row, so I decided to leave them in. And from that point, they really played well through the end of the half. Start of the second half, we did some good things, and then as I looked up the clock one time, I think we were up like 16, and we had 3 turnovers and a bad shot, 4 possessions. Now all of a sudden, it's a 6-point game. And truthfully, and some of the local guys, and Greg, you guys will laugh at this, I actually almost called a timeout twice. And I told these guys coming down, I started to the second time, and I said, no, these guys got us in this daggum mess, so let's see if they can get us out. I think it's better for our long-term growth as a team, but Luke was sensational as 28-16, 5 assists, and
5 turnovers.
I thought Joel goes to the line when everything is rocking for them, and everybody starts to panic, and he goes to the line, makes both free throws to make it 8. Theo had a big dunk in there. We got a couple of stops on the other end. From that point on, I think, need to say, I think we finished on a 13-0 run or something like that. But I think Kenny and Joel and Luke were really big time for us, and again, Theo did so many things, but Theo and Luke both didn't have the normal game they have, but they're taking care of the basketball. But very happy for us to shoot 49.2%. I think we did miss our first 8 shots or something crazy like that, 8 of our first 9, so you have to be happy about that.
Luke, I know, this isn't surprising for you or your teammates anymore, what you've been doing, but do you feel like you're still catching defenses off guard a little bit? Like,
I feel like going into the game, I'm going to play my game, and my teammates are going to get me open, and I'm going to try to do my best. Coach always says, if you set a screen, you'll make yourself open, and I try to do as much as I can, and then really run the floor, get some easy ones to kind of get in the flow, and I thought I had a great team win today.
Have they been guarding you any differently, like, since, you know, the past 5 games? I mean, does it continue on?
Not really too much different. I mean, we have so many guys that can score. I mean, I think Theo, Kenny, Joel, I mean, they all are capable of hitting shots, getting to the basket, and really tough to guard all 4 of us at the same time.
Joel, we knew coming into the year that the perimeter was going to be a strength. There's question marks about the post. Has Luke kind of alleviated those concerns?
Yeah, I think so. And it's just a different look. Compared to what people have seen the last couple of years. I mean, we usually have 2 guys who are on the block, and now you have somebody who's setting a pick, and he's not rolling to the basket. He can step out and hit the 3. And then Luke is a smart player. I don't think a lot of people realize when Luke gets the ball down low, his shot is just so convincing to where he gets people off their feet, and then he goes up to the basket. And so not only is he giving us stuff from the outside, but in the inside, if you actually look at what he does when he makes a move, people will realize he's just smart. You know, a lot of people just make a move and go straight up, but Luke will get you off your feet, and then he'll go right into you and grab a play and get a foul. So he's a very smart player.
And for both of you guys, Coach alluded to it, they went on a 9-0 run, responded with an 8-2 run. And late, they had a 10-0 run. He's responded with that 13-0 run to close the game. Is that just experience? The ability to respond like that?
I think it really helps having a player like Joel who can really command the floor and really draw fouls and get people in the right spots. But I think Coach challenged us at a timeout, needed a timeout, and really wanted us to fight back and really use our hard-earned brain more. And I think we did that towards the end.
Yeah, I think it helps having that experience. And knowing that, you know, in times we can't panic, we just got to continue to play our game. And then, like Coach said, he was close to calling a timeout, but he knew that we were capable of, you know, withstanding that run. And that he just wanted to see what we could do in that moment. And I think we responded pretty well. And, you know, that's how you close out a game. But he challenged us, and we took on the challenge. And that's one thing about Coach, you know, he's always trying to challenge us to be the best that we can.
That moment he did, and we were able to finish it and come out with the win.
Y'all think one thing, and I'll let these guys finish too, is I'm looking at here, Joel Berry against Arkansas has 4 assists and 0 turnovers. That's pretty doggone good. And another guy that did some nice things for us, we're glad to have him back, was Brandon Robinson. B. Rob plays 15 minutes, gets 5 points. We also had six rebounds, so it's good to have him healthy again. But these two guys make me feel a lot more comfortable here on the bench.
Let the players go. Get to the and let coach, because Arkansas is from the red lines. Like I said, the other players were available outside of the hall.
Y'all with a smaller lineup kind of final, like 8 minutes of the first half, and then again, I mean, he stretches the second half here to the end. What about that smaller lineup? Obviously, it's an advantage, or what do you like about what that lineup brings?
Well, they're guys, I mean, everybody can shoot threes, and it's hard for Garrison, Sterling, and those guys to get out and play. And Trey Thompson, for example, I don't know what he finished up with, but we think he's really had 2 assists and 0 turnovers. When he's out on the floor, he's really a passer, and so matchups weren't great, but we're going to be able to go small, but also I'm very comfortable with 2 big guys in there too, and Garrison, Sterling, and Huff didn't have the stats today that they normally have, but they did some good things. The only thing I'm mad about is when I see 34, 33, 34, 35 minutes, I played the guys too many minutes, so I've got to do a better job.
Are you at all surprised at how well Luke is playing this early this season?
How well
Luke is playing offensively this early?
No. I'm not, guys, because last year, during the season, I told my staff, I said, guys, you guys don't understand, I like Luke better than all y'all put together. And none of them disliked him, but I just think he's a big-time player. I mean, go back and watch the regional. If you watch the regional last year, his numbers were off the charts with very few minutes. And so, no, the young man's really, really intelligent, and he's finally starting to play basketball with his brain involved, too, except for his turnovers.
Have you sensed that other teams don't really have an idea?
Guys, I think they're trying to guard him. They're not giving him carte blanche. Hell, I'm not saying go ahead and go to the basket. I mean, you think those other coaches are dumb? He's got a double-double every game.
No, I'm not 3 games out of 5.
He's had 9 rebounds in every game at least. So.
Yeah,
I'm not double-double.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's the other coaches, they read stats too.
Right.
So, no, what I'm saying is I think Luke is a very intelligent player. If they're going to play him inside, he's still pumped. You know, face what Joel's talking about, gets him off balance, he can take it to the basket, he can step out and shoot to three. It's with Andrew, you guys, some three of you, I know have covered this for a long time. What has given us trouble the last 3 or 4 years is guarding an undersized four man that can go out on the court.
That's what I was getting at.
Yeah, so that's who we are. You know, 100 years ago, Coach Smith said, you'll be great. This is the night before left to go to Kansas. I said, are you sure you're good for this year being your alma mater? And he said, you'll be great. Just be yourself and do what you've always said to us. Let's fit our personnel with what we have. He said, don't ever forget that. You've been pushing that to me forever. And I mean, he's lying because I didn't have to push anything, Coach Smith. He says, play the way your personnel can play.
Coach, thoughts on UConn or Michigan State? Next round?
Thoughts on that. I know how to spell both of them. I know the coaches really well. I respect their programs. I haven't watched 1 second of either game. Not one second.